Students, 6th English medium. Today we are going to start the revision for the chapter number 2. Let's start with some blanks. Blank is a whole number, but not a natural number. So we know that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 are the natural numbers, whole numbers. And 1, 2, 3, 4 up to going on and on, they are the natural numbers. So here you can see that 0 comes in the whole number, but it is not a natural number. Division by blank is not possible. We already know about it, that when we divide 0, answer is not possible. So division by 0 is not possible. Then on a number line, there does not be any natural number, on the left side of blank. Now we know that if there is a number line like that, we denote the numbers like that. So now there all are the natural numbers. So on the left of which number we don't have any natural number? So you can say that to the left of 1, we don't have any natural number. Because from the left of the 1, there will be 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. So left of the left side of 1, we don't have any natural numbers. Then number 4, the product of two whole numbers is always a blank number. You know the property, closure property for multiplication, that product of two whole numbers is always a whole number. It means the answer is a whole number. Fifth blank. Dash is the additive identity which number is such that we add into any number, the answer becomes the same, that is the 0. So we call that 0 is the additive identity. Blank is the multiplicative identity. We know that when we multiply any number with 1, answer is same itself. So one is the answer, which is the multiplicative identity. Seventh number. 3 plus 5 plus 7 is equal to 3 plus 5 plus 7. Is true by Planck property of addition of whole numbers. So now grouping, when we make the grouping in the addition, it is known as the associative property. Answer is associative property for the addition. Three multiplied by 4 plus 5 is equal to 3 multiplied by 4 plus 3 multiplied by 5 is true by Dash property. So that is the, we know that distributive property. Then next, in whole numbers, associative property holds good for Planck. We know that associative property can be used for both the operations, that is the addition and multiplication. So you can write down both here, addition and multiplication. Then the blank number 10. On a number line, .539 is on the blank side of 935. Now, when the two numbers are there, then the always the smaller number is to the left side of the bigger number. So here 539 is smaller than 935, so it is always on the left side of 935. Now, next question is, write the succession of the each following number. So here what will we do? We will make a table like that. Number and its succession. Then it is easier to write down the answers. Otherwise, you will write down the whole sentence, successor of Phalana, Jigna, etc. So now, take the numbers one by one and on the opposite side, we will write down its answers. Number one, 3, 6, 8, 9. So now, the successor of 3, 6, 8, 9. You must have knowledge about successor. Successor means the number which comes after this number, immediately after. Means we have to just add one in it. So if you add one here, 3, 6, 8, 9, the answer will be 3,690. Second one is 4,799. So 4,799, if you add one, it will be 4,800. Then 9,999. So if you add one in that number, you will get 10,000. Fourth one is 8,798. So the number will be 8,799. So it is very, very simple to write down the successor of the given numbers. Let's take another one more. Like 4,840. So it will be 4,841. Similarly, take other question of the predecessor. Write the predecessors of each number. So here also we will make a number and its predecessor. First, we will take ₹5,000. Now, predecessor means that coming just before it. So, we have to subtract one here. So, from 5,000, if you subtract one, you get 4,999. Second number is 3,790. So from 90, subtract 1, you will get 89. So 3,789. Then you can take 5,999. Now, don't write down by mistake the successor. Otherwise, with the same thing that yes, it will be 6,000, but here we have to write down the predecessor, so minus 1. So, 5,998 will be the answer. So it will be 9,998 is the answer. Now, we will take some examples of the addition and subtraction on number line. So, add using a number line. So when we add the whole numbers on number line, you have to understand how to do it. It is very, very simple. In which we have to start with the first number and then while adding we have to move to the right side. And we have to jump only one step according to what steps are given. Let's take number one. Let's take 3 plus 4. So here on number line the zero we can take anywhere and then at equal distance. Need not be that it should be 1 centimeter, it can be 2 centimeters also, but the distance between all the digits must be equal. So, we write down like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now we have to start from the number 3. So at number 3 we will make a vertical line on it. Now we have to add, it means we have to move to the right side. How many places? We have to add 4, so we have to make 4 jumps. So there will be a first jump, second jump, third jump and fourth jump. And so that we are going to move that place 4 steps. What came 7? So here we have to write down moving to the right of 3 we get 7. Therefore 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. So while using the number line, just you have to jump one step on the right side. Let's take one more example. Take 2 plus 6. So here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now what is the first number 2? So we have to start from number 2 and jump 6 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So how many steps we move 6 and we get 8. So moving to the right of 2, we get 8. Therefore, 2 plus 6 is equal to 8. That will be your answer. So that is why, that is the way we do this addition. In the next, we will learn about subtraction and multiplication also using number line. So here we are going to stop today's session. It will be followed by PDF file, maybe some more examples for yourself, practice also. Write down in the notebook, and any confusion please write down in the comment section. Thank you.